Kingdom Center, the center of life. An excerpt from Tao Shuk Buddha Upanishad, Volume 2, Religion Without God. Someone asks how one should find the internal center that is mentioned by Lao Tse and develop its hunger. When I have decided, and the chief editor, the compiler of this book, Tao Shuk Buddha Upanishad, Volume 2, Religion Without God, gave me the title Religion Without God. It marks a great responsibility. If God is not the center, then who is the center? And where will you find the center if man is the center? So the topics, the subjects, the talks were very important, because you are dealing with the development of human consciousness and birth of a new man. This is the way for the new man to emerge. Sit with your eyes closed and think, where is the center of my body? We live through our body. But it is an unfortunate fact that we do not give any thought to the center of our body. We are completely ignorant of the pivot on which the body functions, or the axle through which the wheel of the body continues to move. Many people believe that the head is the center of the body to function, because it is the brain that all activities seem to take place. It is through and in the brain that all activities seem to take place. The fact, however, is different. Brain forms much later. When the child is conceived, there is no brain, and yet the life functions. But that which is formed later cannot verily be the center, because in the fetus, the brain forms not in the beginning, but during the third and the sixth months of the pregnancy. There is no brain, and yet life functions. But that which is formed later cannot verily be the center. People who are emotional, like most women, artists, poets, they feel the center to be the heart, because whatever these people have known and experienced, love, beauty, and life, certainly these things have a direct impact on their heart. That is why when people talk of love, their hand inevitably goes to their heart. So those who are emotional take the heart to be the center of the body. But the heart does not beat until the child takes the first breath. When the child is born and takes the first breath, then the heart begins to function. So how can heart be the center of life when 9 months were spent in the womb and you were continuously living? The child hears mother's heartbeat within it. Therefore, the sound tick tick causes not only children but even the adults to fall asleep. The sound of water dripping or the ticking of the watch induces sleep. Doctors say that the ticking of the clock is a very good tranquilizer. Remember ticking of the sound, it goes rhythmically. There is no variations. And if you can keep on listening to the ticking of the clock, you can fall asleep. The heart embryo, the heart in the embryo does not function like a heart, yet a child is alive. Therefore, heart also is not the center. Lao Tzu says the navel is the center and not the heart or the brain. Navel is the center and not the heart or the brain. The child is joined to the mother by its navel through umbilical cord. The first glimpse of life comes through the navel. It is scientifically correct, and meditation is the umbilical cord that connects you to the existence. And meditation is the umbilical cord that connects you to the existence. So search deep within. Lao Tzu says, keep searching within and bring your consciousness to the level of the navel center. This is the first step of spiritual austerity. Keep searching within and bring your consciousness to the level of the navel center. This is the first step of sadhana or austerity. When the authentic center, the center of your understanding become one, the authentic center and the center of your understanding become one, you will become united, integrated and harmonized. When the authentic center and the center of your understanding become one, you will become united, integrated, harmonized and whole. When the center of your mind and the center of your consciousness, when the center of your mind, which is the center of your consciousness and your authentic center, concentrate and converge on one single focus, you will find that your life has changed. You are now a new person altogether. You are totally transformed. This is the birth of a new man, integrated and harmonized within and without. Lao Tzu's disciples have for ages been carrying out a simple experiment to prove that you cannot grow unless you locate your center within. The experiment is this: take two small tanks of equal dimension, fill them with water, immerse an iron rod in the middle of one tank. Immerse an iron rod in the middle of one tank, leaving the other as it is. Take two identical fish and put one in each tank. Given the same condition and the same diet, you will be surprised to find that the fish in the tank with the iron rod in the center. Given the same condition and same diet, you will be surprised to find that the fish in the tank with the iron rod in the center develops quickly, whereas the growth of the fish in the other tank, which is without the central rod, is slower. The fish in the former tank swims around and around the rod, while the fish in the other tank has no center. In the first tank, the fish swims around the rod that is there in the center as the pivot. While the fish in the second tank has no center, it swims here and there listlessly in the absence of the center and is also more prone to illness. If you have not discovered your center, you are prone to illness of various dimensions. This experiment has been religiously carried out by the disciples and the followers of Lao Tzu hundreds of years, and has always been found that the fish in the tank with the center rod has always been well developed and healthy, whereas the fish in the other tank was stunted in growth and was unhealthy. The followers of Lao Tzu meditate that the person who succeeds in locating his center finds his consciousness revolving around his center. It is only then that his consciousness begins to develop. Those who do not find their centers remain inhibited, impeded, and lifeless, like the fish in the other tank. Because they have no center, no base around which they can revolve and develop, they cannot find their direction where they should go, what they should do. By revolving around the same circumference, the consciousness develops. Lao Tzu says your consciousness becomes concentrated when it discovers the navel center. Then it begins to revolve around it. When you walk, keep your attention on the navel. When you sit, keep your mind on the navel. When you get up, be aware of the navel center. Do what you will, but let your consciousness always move around the navel. Become a fish and go round and round the navel. You will soon discover a new powerful consciousness arising within you. The results are wondrous. There are many experiments that you carry out. You are sitting on a chair. A simple thing, you are sitting on a chair. Lao Tzu says your way of sitting on the chair is wrong. Therefore you get tired. Lao Tzu says your way of sitting on the chair is wrong. That is why you get tired. He says do not sit on the chair. He says do not sit on the chair. This does not mean that you are not actually to sit on the chair. The words of the masters have not to be taken literally. And do not bring in your mind either, saying that I do not sit on the chair, I sit in the chair. You are bringing your intelligence into it, your intelligence in front of a master. He will simply laugh and leave you aside. Lao Tzu says, do not sit on the chair. Wait and listen what he is going to say next. This does not mean you are not actually to sit on the chair. That you should sit on the ground. No, Lao Tzu does not say so. This is what you infer when you hear Lao Tzu's words. Lao Tzu says, sit on the chair, but do not put your weight on the chair. Lao Tzu says, sit on the chair, but do not put your weight on the chair. Put your weight on your knee. You can carry out the experiment right. It is only a matter of emphasis. When we put all our weight on the chair, The emphasis is on the chair. The chair becomes the all in all. You are merely like a coat hanging on a peg. If the peg breaks, you fall down. It is like a coat that has no center of its own and which depends on the peg for its center. Lao Tzu says, you will tire yourself this way because you are not acting like an enemy consciously. You are dependent entirely on the inanimate object. You are acting like a coat which is hanging on a peg. Coat does not have a center, but you are a living being. Anyway, you must discover your center first. Lao Tzu says, sit on the chair, but be fixed at your own center at the table. Your gaze, your consciousness, your attention should be fixed on your knee. Sit on the chair, but be fixed at your own center at the knee. Hang everything on the peg of the knee. Hours will go by and you will feel no sign of fatigue. Hang everything on the peg of the knee. Hours will go by and you will find no sign of fatigue. If a man begins to live by hanging his consciousness on the peg of the navel center, all mental fatigue vanishes. If a man learns and begins to live by hanging his consciousness on the peg of the navel center, all mental fatigue vanishes. A unique freshness pervades his mind. A serene calmness flows within him and he gains self-confidence, which only those who have found their center attain. So the first step of this sadhana or austerity is to find your center and then to continue your efforts till the consciousness reaches not only the navel, but in fact 2 inches below the navel center. Then one should begin to keep the center always in mind. First carry your consciousness to the center of the navel, which is 2 inches, 2 finger width below the navel and 2 inches deep inside. The center is 2 finger width below the navel center, your navel, and 2 inches deep within. When one breathes in, the center should rise up, and when one breathes out, the center should go down. The constant movement of the navel center up and down. As you breathe in, it goes up, and when you breathe in, it goes down. This is a constant japa, a mantra, a repetition. Not that you take a word and you continue to chant that 100 times or a certain required number of times. What is very important is constantly watching is this rising and fall of the navel center as the breath comes in and breath goes out. The rising of the center with the incoming breath and falling of the center with the outgoing breath is the only mantra that one should repeat and worth repeating. If this becomes a conscious act, it yields great results. This is very difficult, of course, in the beginning, because remembrance is most difficult to do. Constant remembrance is even more difficult. You might say that it is not such a difficult thing at all. I can recollect the names of a person even after 6 years. This is not remembrance. This is recollection. And the Hindi word for recollection is smriti. You have read something, you are recollecting it. Understand the difference. Recollection means you know something, you pass it on to your memory for recording, the memory stores it, and then whenever it is needed, it comes to the surface. The information comes to the surface and then recollection reproduces it on the demand. Remembrance, on the other hand, is smaran. It means constant, non-stop remembering. Recollection is something has been stored in your memory and at demand it surfaces. And remembrance means smaran. A constant remembrance, a non-stop remembering. Try it a little. Observe the rising and fall of your abdomen as breath comes in and goes out, just for 5 minutes. After 2 seconds, you will find that you have forgotten. You have started to do something else. Then you will be disturbed. You could not concentrate for even 2 seconds. The respiration was going on as usual and the abdomen also rose and fell accordingly. But you were not there. Then again bring back your remembrance. If you strive continuously, you remember. Your remembrance will increase second by second. If you strive continuously, your remembrance will increase second by second. When you find that you can observe the breath constantly without a break for 3 minutes, and this short interval of 3 minutes will seem like 3 years, then you will find that you have begun to experience the center correctly. When you find that you can observe the breath constantly without a simple break for 3 minutes, and this short interval of 3 minutes will seem like 3 years, then you will find that you have begun to experience the center correctly. Then you will feel the body to be separate from the center. The center is the center of energy. One who is united to the center reaches the infinite adoration because he is constantly receiving infinite energy. He is connected to the unfathomable reservoir. So keep a constant remembrance of the navel center and let your consciousness revolve around it constantly. That is the temple. Keep circling around this temple. Whatever be the state within you, whether there is anger or hatred, jealousy or misery, happiness or sorrow, whatever the state, your first duty is to return to the navel. Then do whatever you wish to do. Love or hate, be jealous or miserable, that is a second thing. Someone gives you a news of the death of a loved one, go back to your navel first. Then let the news go within you. Lao Tzu says, then no one's death will cause a blow to the mind. Someone gives you the news of the death of a loved one, go back to the navel. then let the news go with thee. Lao Tzu says that no one's death will cause a blow to the mind. You may not have observed, or perhaps you have, and maybe you realize later on, recollecting the incident, that whenever you have been given the news of a great joy or sorrow, the first effect has always been on the mind. You are walking on the road or cycling or going in a car and suddenly an accident occurs. The first impact of the accident is on the knee. It begins to tremble. Then the whole body begins to tremble. When somebody gives you a joke or you are laughing, you say that do not make me laugh too much, my belly is hurting. We make these kind of statements but without understanding. Lao Tzu says whenever anything happens, go back first to the navel center. Your first work is remembrance of the navel center. Then do what you like. Then happiness will not make you mad with joy, and sorrow will fail to make you unhappy. Then your center will stand apart from the happening that take place on the periphery. Then you remain the witness. Yoga says practice the sadhana of witnessing. Lao Tzu says remember the navel center constantly, and the witness state will result by itself. Remember the navel center constantly, and the witness state will result by itself. You will step outside the birth and death the day you become conscious of your navel center. Because this center comes into existence before birth and is the only thing that remains after death, when all else is lost. So he who knows and recognizes this navel center knows that there is no birth for him or death. He becomes beyond birth. Keep constant remembrance. Seek the center and keep incessant remembrance. Smarana. Incessant remembrance. The first step is to find the center. The first step is to find the center. Second step is to keep on remembering it. And the third is to remember the frequent loss of the remembrance. You are remembering the center. All of a sudden a gap comes, a slip, you forget it. So first you become aware of the center, then remember it. And third, to remember the frequent loss of this remembrance. This is going to be a rather difficult. However, people come to me and say, I try to keep my attention on the navel, but I cannot. What should I do? Keep attention on the fact that you have lost attention. Keep attention on the fact that you have lost attention. Make an effort. Make it a part of your meditation. Be attentive to inattention as well. Do not let it pass unnoticed by you. Whenever you slip, be conscious of the slip and you will go back to remembrance. The current of meditation will join the mainstream again. There will be no discontinuity. You have observed at times, even after the week, I begin where I have left the last time. because there has never been any discontinuity in consciousness. Once you have discovered your center, there is never a discontinuity in consciousness. I may answer something while the meditation session is going on, but I can come back to the same line where I had left earlier. You can try this anytime. Now, one last thing is there to remember. When the remembrance is complete and the center becomes clear to you, and you experience the center, then surrender everything to the center. Say to the center, "You alone are the master. Release." This surrender is easy. Surrender is very difficult until the center is experienced. People say, the religious preceptor says, surrender to God. But we have not known God, we have no knowledge, no understanding of God. How is surrender to an unknown entity possible? And even if God is known, you still remain the owner of your own surrender. If you feel sometime that God is not to your taste, you will withdraw your surrender. We are the givers and we are the withdrawers. What can God do? But the surrender that can be withdrawn is no surrender. In fact, it was never surrender. Lao Tse's method is difficult. He says the day the center is known and felt, you begin to understand and experience that the center is the master that does not need your assistance. It was breathing. It was living even before your brain was developed. So your center is not dependent on your brain or heart. It is the master of the both. Your center was existing before brain came into existence. And before you start, took the first breath and the heart, took the first heartbeat, it was there. So your center is the master, not the brain, not your heart, not your consciousness. The center is beyond everything, beyond the consciousness, beyond the brain, beyond the heart. The breath comes, the day the center is known and felt, you begin to understand and experience that the center is the master that does not need your assistance. The breath comes and goes, sleep comes, then awakening, birth happens and death. The current of life flows on from the center without your help. Then the question of surrendering does not arise, because surrender just happens. Surrender just happens of its own accord. So the third and the last stage of sadhana is to experience the center, experience the surrender to the center. Because you have realized that the center always existed even before you form the first syllables, even before your heart took the first heartbeat, the center existed. So the third and the last step of sadhana, austerity, is to experience the surrender to the center. Then there is no way for ego to save itself. In the state of such surrender, a person reaches to the highest attainment, the ultimate. In that, the person reaches to the highest statement. So the third and the last stage of sadhana is to experience the surrender to the center. Then there is no way for the ego to save itself. In the state of such surrender, a person reaches the highest attainment of the ultimate. The highest attainment of the ultimate. This is navel center, the center of your life. An excerpt from Taushabuddha Upanishad, Volume 2, Religion Without God.